G'day fellas, welcome to a video where we're going to be taking a look at a build order for the Chinese. This is the Chinese Lancer Fast Castle. I'm playing up against an AI so that we've got a controlled environment. Let's get into it. We're going to start by dropping down a house with four villages. We're going to queue up some villages in the town center. We're going to use two villages to build a lumber camp. The next four villages are going to go straight over to the sheep, and then we're going to gather the sheep that's around our town center with our scout. Not with our town center, with our scout, like that. Also putting a scout onto hotkeys in our town center as well. We're going to use the first villager out of the town center, comes down onto the sheep, and we're going to drop off those sheep. Now we're going to go searching for the sheep around our base. So typically on Arabia, there should be five sheep that are very close to your base. They might be in different spots. So here you can see there's one sheep. And we're going to continue looking now for those sheep. One of the things to note is that when you're chopping wood, always want to be chopping from the same tree with your villagers. Once you've got six villagers gathering food, you're then going to transition over to gold, and you're going to be moving two villagers out onto gold. Going to be making sure that you drop down a mining camp. And the idea for placing the lumber camp or the mining camp is you want to think about where the best place to have it defended is. And so typically, if you're against, say, a British player or an English player rather, they're going to be pushing into you with longbows. So you want to make sure that you're able to defend it. So I'm going to be placing my Barbican of the Sun in the front of the base. So just like this, I'm going to be placing it to cover any potential threats from the opponent. At the same time, we've still got these six villages back here, and continuing villager production. Once you've got two villages onto two villages on your gold, then you're going to begin looking or heading out to your hunt. So I'm assuming that my hunt is somewhere in this forward direction. There it is right there. And so I'm going to begin milling my hunt. I'm also going to be using my scout to push in the hunt, get it a little bit extra close. So we'll drop that down just like that. So now I can use my scout to push each of these hunts in just slightly closer. And the idea is that we want to kill these guys right on top of the mill itself. So there you can see we've got one very close to the mill, and that's exactly how we want to be doing it. So our villagers are continuing to come out. So we're just going to allocate them back down over here. And once we've got the mill up, we're going to start researching survival techniques. So that's going to increase the villager gather rate for huntables. Now, when it comes to this technology, we're not actually going to be sending out extra villagers onto the mill or onto this hunt out here until we've actually researched that technology. In the meantime, we're just going to be using them over here on the sheep. At the same time, continuing to herd in these huntable deers and just make sure that they're nice and close underneath the mill. As we've been doing for most of the game, it's important to get these guys in nice and close, just like that. That way the drop-offs are a lot closer and easier for them. Don't be afraid to queue up lots of villagers as well. And now we're also, once this gets to about halfway, as you can see, our next villager out of the town center is going to come out onto berries. So I'm going to bring him down over here. He's going to go to berries, and then he's going to go to gold after that. And then once you get to about three quarters of the way up, you can then start to transition your villagers out. But the timeline that I use is when I start researching wheelbarrow. So you can see wheelbarrow is about to begin getting researched right now. You can see our macro down in the bottom left-hand corner is pretty darn tight. So once that is the case, we're going to be researching wheelbarrow. There it is. And so now I'm going to be transitioning my villagers over to the front of my base. So typically the rule is I want to have a total of 9 on my mill. But seeing as I've overgathered slightly here, I'm only going to move just a handful over. We might get 4 out there for now. And then in the transition period, I'm going to continue having villagers move out over onto the town center. It's important that when you're doing this that you're cognizant of the resources that you're gathering up and making sure that you're not overgathering. So you can see that we're sitting pretty happily on food at the moment. So as a result, I've got a lot more villagers on gold than I normally would at this point in time. So the idea is, so now that I've got all of my my deer down at the moment underneath my mill, I'm in a pretty decent position here, so I'm not too fussed. Once I've got, as I mentioned, 9 villagers that are doing or are on gold, then I'm going to be able to drop this one down. We'll drop it down a house as well while we're on the way. And now that we've got all of our villagers out here, we're going to be transitioning villagers over onto sheep. This is really key, that your villagers are going to be going onto sheep. And the reason why you want them on sheep and you don't want them on deer is because you're going to be transitioning them off once you hit the third age. So now in the transition period, once again, continuing to just scout around, look for sheep out on the map. You can be scouting out your enemy. I'm not too fussed on scouting at the moment, primarily because we actually might bring these guys in. It's more important that we bring them in on a close deer. So I'm not too fussed with scouting at the moment because, as you guys are aware, this is against an AI. Continuing to train villagers and just dropping down the Barbican of the Sun with two villagers. It doesn't need to go down super fast. The English especially aren't too much of a threat in the early game. Not until they've aged up to the second age. That's when it becomes a little bit more concerning. But as you can see, our age up's relatively competitive. About a 5:30 age up time here. So that's about standard. And just two villagers on wood. And at the same time behind this, we're slowly beginning to gather more food and more gold as we look to age up to the third age. So keep in mind, this is a fast castle. So that's the build that we're looking to achieve. So I'm going to transition just a few villagers over onto food from gold, because I noticed that we're gathering up quite a fair bit of gold here. So it's important to just balance that out, make sure that you are watching them. You'll begin to learn the rates as well. But even this is probably a bit too many villagers on gold. So once again, we'll continue transitioning villagers over as we get closer to aging up in the transition period. So you've got these two guys on wood here. So you don't actually need to have these two guys on wood, but it's my preference to have them on wood because it enables you to transition into your stables a lot easier. And typically when you fast castle, you're going to want to have a stable up as quickly as possible. So you can see this villager coming in now, placing down that last, extra 15 wood so that I can drop that stable now. And keep in mind with the Chinese, because they do build their buildings much faster than any other civilization, when you're getting housed, so as an example, let's say I'm at 30 of 30, I can actually just drop a house and I'm not going to get housed. As long as I drop it down immediately, it's still going to build faster than my villager builds. So something to be cognizant of. Now you can see we're getting nice and close to that age up time. So I'm going to get my villagers in here to drop that off and drop down our Imperial Palace. Nice and competitive time here, aging up just before 7 minutes. We're putting it in the front of our base because we're not too fussed about it. Keep in mind, as the Chinese, you're going to be building your wonders a lot faster than your opponents. And now in the transition period, that's when we're transitioning our villagers over and begin dropping down. We've got our stable that we're going to drop down, train some more villagers as well. And the idea is we want this stable finished as soon as we hit the third age so that we can begin assaulting the enemy, potentially looking for villagers, get those all-important units trained out. Dropping down an extra house as well. And now immediately using spies, we can see where our enemy villages are and where we're going to be targeting. There's a nice spot out here that we're definitely going to be heading down. And we've got plenty of villages that are idle, so make sure you shift click them. And now we're going to begin training the Lancer from our stables. As we get more and more wood, we're going to be closer to dropping down additional stables. So this village is coming in, we'll drop down a stable with her. So we want to keep adding stables after this period and make sure that your town center does not go idle. You want to continue adding more villages to your sheep, and eventually when you need to move on to your berries as well. Keep in mind, you've already got your mill down here. If your enemy is aggressive towards you in the early game, don't be afraid to move off your deer and move back to your berries. The berries are going to enable you to have a safe form of resources that you can gather from, or your sheep, which is even better. Obviously they're underneath the town center. I've been quite fortunate in that my wonder has been built very close to my mill here at the front. But essentially what I would do for the rest of the game is I would continue adding stables. So I would add my third stable now. I would continue training lances out of these stables. I would look to hit my opponent from all directions with the lances, and at the same time have my Imperial Palace ready to be using Imperial spies. That's your look at the Chinese fast castle. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button. If you think that I missed something, make sure you leave a comment, or if you've got any questions, let me know down below. Is there any other videos that you'd like to see posted on the channel? If so, make sure you let me know. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.